What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back, and I am happy to announce one of my new series for Ghosts, which is called Rate This Gun. And how this works is I have 8 categories, and I'll go through them for each gun, give them a check mark or give them a red X, and then we'll have a total rating at the end of the video for the gun. So if you guys would, drop a like, share this around, and we'll get started on it. We're going to go through every gun in Call of Duty Ghosts. It'll take a while, but it's something we don't have to be in a rush to do. So we're going to start off with the SC-2010, and you're watching some gameplay. Pretty sure it's Blitz. It is Blitz. There's a KEM strike that goes on. You get to see all that good stuff. So enjoy that in the background, and we're going to get started with this. And the first category is killing power. And remember, this is my opinion. This is me rating this gun. For you guys to give your opinion, you can put it in our brand new comment section, or you can tweet at me on Twitter. So, killing power. In that category, what that means to me is, when I put bullets on target, am I going to be able to assume that this guy's dead after a certain amount of time with my finger on the trigger, and then I can turn and go somewhere else? And with this gun, I say yes. It has the AR stopping power, which it should. This is one of the first guns you get your hands on when you're in Call of Duty Ghosts as well. And I feel confident with this thing when I get in a gunfight if I get bullets on target first. So check mark for killing power. Second one is iron sight friendly. Not really. When you ADS with this, it really seems to hinder what you're seeing as it ADSs, as it's in the actual motion. And then you have the circle and then the sight, and it kind of cuts off the peripheral. It bugs me, so I'm going to give that one a negative. That's going to get a red X. Next is gun sex appeal. Is this gun sexy? Well, you could put, that's up for debate, because you could put different camos on it, but just in the overall scheme of how the gun looks, I'm going to say no. I don't think this is one of the sexier guns in the game. I don't like the iron sights on it, so that one is going to be a negative as well. Next is fire rate and recoil. This is a typical assault rifle for Call of Duty Ghosts, and the fire rate is 750 rounds per minute, and the recoil is not that bad. You can add foregrip, or you can add different stuff to help with that, but in the end game, just as a naked, no attachment gun, the recoil is okay and the fire rate's decent, so I'm going to give that a check mark. Next one is ammo and reload. And this thing starts off with 30 plus 60 in multiplayer, and the max ammo is 30 plus 180. I don't know the reload time, but I do know that it's pretty average for an assault rifle. So it's nothing special, but if you're going to put on, you can put on certain perks that would help out with that. So that really kind of negates that. So I'm going to give this a plus as well. Next, we have accuracy and range. Range, what I'm going for there is, how far away can you still get damage with these? Now, you can put on the muzzle brake and get increased damage range, which you can do that with any gun. So we're just going with bare stock, and this has good accuracy and good range. The recoil is not that bad, and this thing will definitely get somebody across the map. And the damage drop-off isn't that bad as well. To me, remember, these are all my opinions straight off feel. I don't go off the numbers and the analytics and break it down into fractions. I'm going off how it feels to me. You're watching my gameplay, and that's where I directly correlate where I get my opinion. So I'm going to give a check mark to accuracy and range. Next one is a big one, the debug factor. And what that means is this gun considered a debug in the community? If you're running around with this, are you automatically labeled as a douchebag? No, you're not. This is a standard gun. This is one of the first guns that you get in Call of Duty Ghosts, so people are going to expect you to be using this. They're not going to mind if you trick this thing out. This does not get an X in the debug factor. Next and last is mobility. This is an assault rifle, so not putting any perks on to change that. This isn't very mobile. It's more mobile than, say, an LMG, but not as mobile as an SMG, of course, so I'm going to give that an X. This isn't a mobile gun. This is more of a stand back and fight. You can hit fire. You can get in there, because the damage is good, but I wouldn't call this a mobile gun. So there you go, guys. My overall rating out of the 8 categories for the SC-2010 is a 5 out of 8. Let me know what you guys rated it. And remember, the debug factor, if it's a debug gun, it's going to get an X. If it's not a debug gun, it gets the check. Drop a like if you guys enjoyed it. Be sure to check out the video on the screen. And let me know what gun you want to see next on Rate This Gun. I hope you guys enjoyed the new series. I'll see you later.